Wales, Mike Baird, on the air with us this morning.
Hello, sir.
Welcome to the studio.
Well, this is very flash, isn't it?
It's very flash in here, isn't it?
How's the job going? You enjoying it?
Very much so. I mean, it's crazy. There's a lot to do, but it's exciting.
Is it different to what you imagined?
It's always different. I think in any job you go to, you anticipate. There are some things that are the same, some things wildly different. And on a balance, though, love it.
You were the treasurer before you were the premier, right?
That was right.
So you're just counting coins all the time from the parking meters.
Pretty much. Yeah, pretty much.
It would have been piles of coins and then...
And boring,
now,
very boring.
Oh, it would have been, yeah. It's just money.
No, that's right.
So when you made the switch, did you have any ground rules laid out from the family in terms of, you know, making time for them and being able to balance the job with family life?
Yeah, I mean, it's the hardest thing.
Yeah.
The hardest thing is the family. They were used to it. I mean, in the treasurer's job, it did lots of demands, but certainly trying to carve out each week time for the family remains a priority.
Yeah.
How old are your kids?
17. My eldest just finished the HSC yesterday, so she's, I don't know what she's doing today, but she's very happy.
She'll be relaxing today.
Right.
All the pressure's off.
And then 15 and 11.
Do they use your power to get things like the front of the tuck shop line, all that? Excuse me, Premier's kid here, pardon me. excuse me.
Not really, but my youngest was interested in a girl and he wasn't having much luck, but when she found out that his dad was Premier, she became interested. And I said, use it. Use whatever you can.
If my dad was a Premier every day, I'd be showing up to school, flags on the car, big convoy of police. Excuse me. I'd love it. I would have loved that.
Yeah,
your kid's probably a bit more grounded.
What kind of convoy do you have? Is it low-key?
It's a Toyota Kaluga.
Is that it?
That's it. You don't get all the traffic lights turning green for you?
Unfortunately, no.
No, nothing like that.
I would have thought you had a remote control. As on approach, you just click and the lights go green.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah. What's the point of being the Premier?
What's the perks of being the Premier?
What have I got to do?
Well, wine's out, obviously.
No, what's that?
You can't get any wine or anything for free. We've established all that. That's
no, awesome. I mean, I got to meet Prince Edward.
Oh, yeah.
Is that a perk?
Yeah.
Prince Edward.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind meeting Edward.
I like that.
Yeah.
Hey, so there's a few things that on the agenda for the government. You're in charge of it. Now, I saw on the news the other week something about a beach being made on the Parramatta River. Do you know anything about this?
I've seen it. Well, it's a council plan.
Oh, so that's not you. That's not local. Don't ring local council. Just get rid of them. Abolish local council.
That plan, though. Don't you like that plan?
I do like the idea of a beach on Parramatta River. A lot of people down there were very for it, some were against it.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I'd do it.
Yeah.
It'd be nice to get out of, if you're working in Parramatta, go down and relax on the... sure, you wouldn't get in the water. It's rancid. But it'd be nice to relax on the beach. I like that.
Mike, we're going to do a little game with you called Reality Check. Just asking you a few everyday questions. When was the last time you did certain things? Now, we know you're Premier, so you probably, get driven around, and so you're not going to do some of these things, but let's go through the list. Okay.
He knows how to drive.
Well, that's one of the questions. When was the last time you filled your car up with petrol?
On the weekend.
Nice. Tick. Last time you were on public transport.
Public transport on the ferry a couple of weeks ago.
I love the ferry, don't you?
I love it. It's the best commute in the world.
Yeah, Jackie thinks it's like P&O Fairstar, the fun ship, in all honesty. She goes out, it's like a family adventure.
It's a day out for us, yeah.
Hey, I've noticed, by the way, no, you didn't take my idea and put ads on the trains yet. There's coin to be made there, Mike.
Oh, no, I remember you did mention that when I first came into the role.
But you've done nothing.
In fact, Jackie, I wasn't there.
I lost my voice.
Oh, you were sick.
Yeah. Well, I was here. I was hovering around, but I just had lost my voice that day.
Yeah.
Why are you going...
I'm just trying to make it sound sus, but there's no susness, really. You reckon you put ads on the train? Because we should get a free ad for bringing it up.
I'll tell Gladys. Yeah. I'll tell Gladys.
Now, Gladys should be all over. What's Gladys doing?
She's doing a lot of things.
Okay, next question. Made. Last time you passionately kissed your wife.
I can't share that.
Yeah,
I can't share that.
She felt awkward asking that
share,
question.
But it's regular.
It's regular. Good on you, Mike.
Well, you seem surprised. like a person in his position does not have any passion in their life.
Do you binge watch TV shows?
I don't binge watch, no. Mm. I mean, I'm a tragic for sport.
Okay.
I mean, I tape any sport and watch that late at night.
Do you watch reality TV?
Well, we watched The X Factor and The Voice in the household. So
yeah. What about the Keeping Up with the Kardashians? How's that Scott Disick's form, eh?
Well, I cannot in any way comment on the Kardashians. My daughters watch it.
Yeah,
but
right.
I counsel them and tell them that is inappropriate activity. That can't be good for you. And I'm shocked that you watch it, Kyle.
Oh, I've got to. Girlfriend makes me watch. I don't get a choice on TV anymore.
watching Real Housewives of everything.
She got home from the Melbourne Cup last night, and I was settling. I was 5 minutes into Person of Interest. Great show.
Yeah.
And she walks and grabs the remote. Hey, babe, kiss. And as the kiss is happening, the left hand clicks it over to Geordie Shore or something. And then I was, no choice. Do you get a choice on what you watch, or is the wife in charge?
Well, no. When I watch TV, it's generally late, so it's generally a solo affair.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Is that? Do you watch the solo thing on the internet as well?
Don't ask that.
Don't bring your habits into it, Tom.
What about the last app you downloaded?
The last app? Well, it was my son put it on. It was some game. I've no idea.
For himself?
Yes.
Yeah, not for you to kill time with.
No.
Okay.
The Hurley Surf app is probably the last one I put on.
What's that?
Oh, that enables you to check surf across various beach locations.
Oh, that's right. You used to surf with Mr. Abbott, didn't you?
Well, occasionally we do. Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, do you get out there in your bloody Speedos and your chat?
No.
It's like very mafioso out there, isn't it?
No, Speedos, that's his thing.
Yeah, it's his thing, yeah.
Yeah, what do you rock?
Well, boardies.
Boardies, yep, fair enough.
Rashies. So I had a good wave on the weekend, actually.
Did you? Look at you go.
I love it. I love that all the politicians are all sporty. What would you do if you were a Mr. Abbott out there in the water and you saw Clive Palmer come over a wave paddling towards you just for a hangout chat?
Move to the next break.
I like Clive. He's a bit of a wombat, though, isn't he?
I can't imagine him in the surf.
Nah, why? More just like on the sand.
Stop. Premier, thank you for joining us this morning. It's been fun having you in here. And I know the West Connects is something that's really important to you, and that's what you're pushing at the moment, right?
Yeah, so what do we need to know about that before you go?
Well, it's almost the biggest bottleneck in the Southern Hemisphere, those tunnels. So,
yeah, awful. Everyone hates them.
Yeah, so what we're doing is we're fixing it. Not just fixing it, we're future-proofing. So almost over doubling the capacity, which means that huge bottleneck will be relieved, which with all the families going up and down in the turns of the southwest, the distance will be cut in half in some instances.
Are you double decking it the double decker, like another freeway above the top of the existing freeway? Is that what the plan is?
No, just tunnels.
Just tunnels.
I didn't realise you were an infrastructure zone.
Yeah. Oh man, I know everything. I've travelled around. And I've said, look at that. Bloody Japanese know what they're doing.
I don't know what your problem is with tunnels. I think that looks a lot better than those double-decker things.
Yeah, look, mine's not good on the eye.
Yeah, well, why do you want it then?
I don't know. I just like I reckon it's quicker, isn't it?
Looks like Blade Runner to you, does it?
Yeah, I just want things to be quick.
Well, that's exactly what this will be.
It's good.
You cut your travel times in half.
Right. Oh. How long will it take?
Liverpool to the city.
How long till the tunnel's ready?
2019.
2019?
Oh, he'll be dead by then.
No,
he won't. Time for you to see it.
2019, I'll be still alive.
Not according to Woman's Day, you won't.
You can't believe everything you read in Woman's Day. So what's your plan for the day now? Where are you off to?
Into Parliament, preparation for question time, and then I think we're launching the Blue Sox season.
I don't know what that is.
Sydney Blue Sox.
No, well, I have no idea.
That's our
what
baseball team. Our baseball team.
Oh, no, I didn't even know we had a baseball team.
We need to get them in here.
Yeah. Oh, no, not here. We're not into sport, Randy. Have a look. You look at me and think athlete, but
pretty much.
It's just fat. There's no sport in my bones. Well, you folks are out there. Where's your protection man? Do you have a gun-toting guy? Is that him?
How does he look?
Is that your protection? I like the look of him. I like that, you know, the non-obvious security guy. Oh, it's nice to see you, Mr. Baird. Thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you.
No worries.
Appreciate it. Good luck.
Great to have you.
If you ever need to get to all the people, you ring us up.
No good
wasting away on Alan Jones with his 250,000. We got like three times the listeners.
This is the station, I understand that.
Oh, and we won't be bloody talking like that either every time you're in and challenging you on things you've done in the past.
The impersonations.
You know who it is? Yeah, you know who it is. Jackie, you do your impersonation.
Oh, come on, Kyle. I don't do one.
She's got some bedroom characters. Do the Asian.
I don't have one, no. Thank you for coming in and joining us.
Thanks, Jackie.
Nice to see you,
Kyle. Good to see you.
See you later.
Thanks.
The Premier, everybody.
You could win 10,000 in cash.